Elvis in 1970. I got a thing that says, Elvis wants to meet you. I got to the Hilton Hotel, elevator opened up, and it was me, Liza Minnelli, Chubby Checker, and Linda Lovelace.
Wow. What, you'd come together, or you just sort of happened to be in that list?
No, he invited those four people.
Really?
That night. So we went up, and they searched us for guns, which was kind of silly, because there were guns everywhere once you got in. When he came in the room, he was Elvis. He wasn't the fat Elvis. He was Elvis. He was the guy. He goes, hey, man, you're the cat with a snake, ain't you? He said, yeah. And he goes, that's cool, man. I wish I would have thought of that. That's cool, man. He said, hey, I want to show you something. We go in the kitchen. He opens the drawer, takes out a loaded 38, snub-nosed 38, puts it in my hand. And he says, I'm going to show you how to take this gun out of somebody's hand. The little devil's here on my shoulder says, shoot him. The little angel over here says, don't kill him, just wound him. Okay. Before I could decide what to do, I was on the floor. And he's had his boot in my throat. I'm going, ha, it's good, Elvis. That's good.
I'm still reeling over the fact that you were there with Liza Minnelli.
Oh, yeah.
He must have thought you were sisters.
Of course, only three of us came down on the elevator that night. Now, I don't know what he did with Chubby Checker all night. I'll tell you what, he was an amazing character, very funny guy.
Wow.
But he was Elvis. Yeah. I mean, you know.
Biog last night, I was reading all about you kids. Who made the mistake over the menstrual cycle?
I wanted to say, in terms of chocolate, I like minstrels, but, like, I said I like menstrels.